bro.
It's not Joe. It's J.O. J.O. Malone Studios.
We even got a special guest for y'all today. We got a special guest, the homie Lil Tay.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Mr. T-A-Y. Bats in the building.
Yes, sir. Y'all in here, yo. We got some hot for y'all today. So make sure y'all keep it locked right here. Tell your cousins. Tell your best friends, your classmates.
Tweet about us.
Tweet about us. Instagram us. You can call in 936-261-3752. Make sure y'all keep it locked. TV, you know, radio, we are back.
Yeah, yeah.
The Kickback, Jazzy Black.
And your girl, DJ 4.0, your favorite DJ.
And the homie Lil Tay in the building. Lil Tay, what's happening?
Tay?
What's happening?
It's Tay.
The people been waiting on you. So, I mean, yo, what's up? You straight out of Houston, first of all.
Yes.
And I mean, how did you even get in the booth to start with? Like, you just woke up one day and was like, you know what?
Yeah, I think I'm about to Dallas.
Go. What? Oh, here we go.
Here we go.
People always want those shades, man.
You came in plexus.
H-Town,
I'm going to make it today.
You know what?
We're going to let him make it today.
We're going to
let
you make it.
We're going to let him make it today.
Woosa. I got you.
But yeah,
after the show, it's me.
I always used to freestyle back in the day. We used to rap, you know, everybody be in the car, you know, blow and just doing the music thing. But then when I got out of prison, actually, while I was in prison, I got serious with the writing. And then, when I got out, well, one of my brothers told me I made one song. And he told me that it was good and keep doing it. And I just kept doing it. And I'm here now.
That's what's up.
You can't stop. That's what people do, man. They stop. And that's where you end up going wrong.
Definitely.
Yeah, for sure. So, I mean, like, are there any artists that you would, like, say you look up to? I wouldn't say compare yourself to. But are there any artists that you influence, you know what I'm saying?
A bunch of artists. Definitely out of Houston. I'm big, like, Chameleonaire, Zero, Paul Wall, all that good stuff. I'm, you know, back in the day, Swisher House, that was my thing. But then, I mean, I'm influenced by just everyday life, so, I just can't pick, you know, an artist that I see myself, you know, being like, but out of those people, there's, you know, a lot of people that I looked up to as a younger cat coming up in the game.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, especially with them doing the independent route, and, you know what I'm saying, Paul Wall and Camino, where they came out with the Get Your Mind Correct.
Right,
you know
and you're an independent artist.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, Terrific Records, my own record label. I came out.
Oh, dang. Yeah, yeah. When'd you start that?
Right when I came out of prison. I told you I'm focused. When I got out, it was get the label, make the music, and now I get the music out to the people.
So you came out and went head first. Like, this is exactly what I'm going to do. Boom, boom, boom. And you went through and executed it.
Oh, yeah.
Dang.
We got a movement. It's called BATS. It stands for Breaking All the Standards.
Okay.
So we breaking every standard you got.
Definitely.
And that's what it's all about.
Dang.
Yes, ma'am.
You're killing it right now. I know.
If
people don't know you, like I know you. Like I know you. It's been about what, 3 years?
A little more.
Yeah. I know you, so I know how the grind is. I know where you were.
Right.
And where you are now.
Right.
And where you're going to go, I can see it too. You know, you got good people on your team.
But we're
right
there together.
Like, you're not going to forget about
come
your girl.
We already had this conversation.
Right.
Got my number.
So, what would you tell people, like, that's really just trying to get in the rap game right now? Like, you know, they don't know that, you know, you've had people on your songs. You know, you had Devin to do. You've had so-and-so. You know, and for people just listening to you right now, like, what would you say to keep the grind up? Or how would you say, you know, everybody wants so-and-so on their record, but, you know, you're not putting in the work.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, first off, I plan on doing music for at least 10 more years.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, my first advice is for if you're going to do any rapping or singing or anything, wait about 10 years, and then you might have a chance.
Nah,
I'm just playing. Nah, but in the game, man, like, it's cutthroat. So, you know, like, you got to get out there, you know, put out your CDs, you know, take them chances, get them no's, get them turn downs, you know, and, like, man, people going to bump their heads, man. I came into the game, and I was just trying to throw money at myself, you know, from a little money that I had stacked before I went to prison. You know, I came out and I used that to try and push forward with the music. And just me not knowing and bumping my head on my own, you know what I'm saying? I ran through that little money, but I gained the knowledge along the way. So now I don't have to sit here and ask somebody, you know, what do I do here? What do I do there? You know,
I heard you saying, like, you know, bumping your head and stuff. So, like, what kind of, like, downfalls, I guess, or what kind of barriers would you say kind of, like, kept you from, like, going forward.
Right, all right. For one of the main things that I see with a lot of young artists nowadays is people believe they can buy themselves into the industry.
Right.
I mean, you can, don't get me wrong, but you gotta have, I'm talking about 50 racks plus. But like these younger cats coming in, mm-hmm. and they have these promoters that just, you know, not all promoters are bad, so don't
get they the, are you janky know, sometimes.
Man, it's a lot of janky promoters, and all they're looking for is a quick buck. And, you know, so they take these artists, they got a dream, you know, want to do something big, you know, all they're looking for is just a chance to perform. And they say, hey, give me $300, I'll let you perform this and that, you know?
Yeah.
And that's what I've seen a lot with the game lately, is pay to play. And my main thing that I say to people, man, is you just got to keep pushing. And if you believe in you, and you just keep doing it, you know what I'm saying? Like, good music, if you got good music, it'll get heard. If you don't have the money to, you know, to put it out, then you just push what you got, and eventually it'll get heard. You know, if you got the money, you skip all that, just, you know, throw it in the hands of the right people.
Yeah, and I think one of the biggest failures to a lot of artists just coming in contact with different people is that a lot of people try to force their image, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it's like, really? People gonna ride with you more tough if you just being genuine.
Being you,
if you just being genuine, people gonna have mad respect for you regardless of, you know what I mean, what anybody else has to say to you.
Right.
And me personally, like, I've been there where, you know, people come in and say, you know, oh, well, I'm gonna do this. Yeah, I rock with you. But then when I call them, they not there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'd rather have five loyal people that's gonna be down for me than 20 people that's in my face saying, you know what I'm saying?
Saying they wish, yeah.
Saying they want what they want.
It's simple case when, all right, when I first started getting my CDs printed, you know. So you got all these people that are around you telling you how much they support you. They love, oh, man, that song jams. Oh, man, bro, you gonna make it. You hot, bro.
Yeah.
Well, hey, bro, do me a favor. Support me and buy my CD for $10. Oh, well, I got to put gas in the car. I got to buy a pack of cigarettes. Or, you know, I need to buy dinner tonight.
Yeah.
But yet, you go to the club every night. You know, but you're supposed to be my partner, you know, like,
right.
So I see that kind of stuff, you know, but I don't let that disturb me or bother me, you know, like, I just keep pushing, and as long as I can do me, you know, and, man, we're just pushing this Relaxin' Blaze album, and, it's R&B, and it stands for Relaxin' Blaze, and it's a new feel, new vibe.
So you're trying to jump to the ladies. Speaking of the ladies.
Man, I love the ladies.
Speaking of the ladies.
Just talk to me.
What's going on with the ladies? You got a special lady?
What you want to know? All you got to do is look at me and talk to me.
Y'all don't even know. You ain't looking me in my eyes and stuff. You got a special lady? Or no?
I mean,
you just kind
of
relaxing?
Yeah, I got a main special lady.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's my mom.
Oh, okay. Shout out to your mom.
I hope mama listening right
and
now.
And then I got a second favorite lady, and that's my little sister.
Oh, little sister. Great. How old is she?
She's 23.
23?
Yeah.
So wait, how many?
I am 25.
25. Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Cool.
Sounds
about right.
Yeah.
So back on this mixtape though. I mean, this album.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So on your album, you know, it's 11 tracks. They all hot.
Yep.
You know, I see One in a Million, UFOs. Now I've heard UFOs personally.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard
featuring Devin the Dude.
Definitely.
The Legend.
Bad Mother. You know, and definitely your single. Wasted.
Oh, yeah.
So we're going to get into Wasted.
I'm
you know,
Wasted.
I don't think nobody knows. Nobody knows how Wasted is about to sound. And I'm not even going to lie. When I first heard Wasted, I'm like, dude, you sound like R. Kelly right now.
Yes.
You sound like R. Kelly. So, I mean, hey, I didn't know you could sing.
But,
yeah. It's hot, though. It's hot.
And what's cool, you know me. So you know the song.
I do.
Fist Me.
And I'm like, okay, all right, Wasted. Okay. Just the people are gonna see, they're gonna hear. We're gonna see. I want people to call in and like tell me how they think about it, you know?
Oh yeah, call in, especially the ladies. Call in, we could talk. I don't know how long I got on the air to talk to you.
You just put your sexy voice on
for the
ladies.
So
I'm
like,
you don't do that sexy voice.
I put that voice
on
for y'all.
Oh, okay.
Alright, here you go. Y'all make sure y'all call in. We about to drop this Lil Tay, Wasted. Yo, who produced the song?
Oh, the song's produced by Chris Rockaway, Rockaway Productions,
okay.
Man. Y'all can get at him at Rockaway Prod on iTunes. At Twitter, my bad. Instagram, Rockaway Prod. And man, he did my whole album, the whole Relaxin' Blaze album. He's a beast, man.
Okay, bet. For sure. DJ 4.0, yo, y'all make sure y'all call in. 936-261-3752.
It's not over. We still got Lil Tay in the building. We're going to continue here. This interview. We're going to let you guys listen to this wasted.
They handcuffed me. And
we're going to come back. You stand here.
It's Tay.
Yo, look, Tay.
That's that fire.
Yeah.
Hey, well, I'm up here bouncing in the seat. Over no, trying to talk to me. I was zoned out.
Man, she's over there getting wasted just listening to it.
Definitely the whole way. Like, I like this song definitely for the reason that I am a lady. Uh-huh. So it's not like we getting wasted.
Yes.
It's definitely something that I can play in the car, you know. If I have kids around me, I can play it, you know.
Yes. It's not over here. Wasted,
you know. I can play this. And I can actually hear this in the club. Uh-huh.
Exactly. So, that's what I was like, we got to get this popping in.
This for the ladies. Yes. So I see what you're doing.
Because I was over here rubbing my fingers through my hand like, yes. I am wasted.
I see exactly what you're doing.
I'm trying. Right. I'm glad that you see it.
I like this.
Yeah.
I'm feeling this. I like this aura. So, I mean, you know, with this being said, I know this is your single.
Right.
We pushing Wasted all day.
Right. It's on iTunes, YouTube, anywhere, everywhere, CD Baby. All you got to do is just Google Lil Tay Wasted, and it's going to pop up everywhere.
Definitely, right. And if y'all get lucky, y'all can come down to the studio right now. We are in the station, and we have some copies.
CD, man, they're going for F-R-E-E if you get down here right now.
If you get down here right now, they are going for
free copies. All you got to do is walk. And you say you get a free workout and free CD.
See, what they don't know, see, you giving out free CDs right now.
I think we should charge for pictures, though.
We can do that.
Yeah, they got to come out something.
Is that somebody calling in for you?
I hope so.
Lil Tay, that's you?
Over here.
You see, this, it's your song, you know. It's Wasted.
I'm pulling them in.
It's something for the ladies.
I'm pulling them in.
For sure. What's your name?
See, look. Okay. Well, definitely, as we see who that is calling, you know.
Oh, yeah.
What's good with your songs on your album right now? So, what would be your favorite song right now? Off your album.
My personal favorite is One in a Million. So the One in a Million is pretty much my childhood was, you know, I didn't have the roughest childhood. My family, you know, we were all right.
Yeah.
But during the middle of my life, you know, I took a turn for the worse. And when I took that turn, you know, it made me realize a bunch of things. And in this One in a Million, it explains my whole time from coming out of prison to all the way until the Relax and Blaze album. And it's just pretty much saying, you know, like, I won't stop, man. You can't tell me to quit, you know?
Okay.
So it's my motivational track. And then Champion featuring Neek, that one just goes hard.
Okay. So if you could choose any of your songs right now, and you could have Drake on it, which one would you choose?
Ooh, to have Drake on it?
Drizzy.
Which one would you choose?
I would do... The Wasted.
You do Wasted?
Yeah, I would do Wasted.
You know what? I think
I can see that too.
I think if you throw Kirko on there, it's over. It's you and Kirko. Y'all took Wasted.
My only problem with the Drake thing was, I don't see him just getting the Wasted. You know what I'm saying? Okay. So I don't know if it's gonna fit in. You know, I know he does the hookah, and I know he probably I just don't know. You know. But to be on the Wasted track, you know, you got to be at least a little wasted.
True. That's
definitely why I said Kirko.
But,
yeah,
you know.
I rock with Kirko.
Hey, yo, and the ladies are calling in. Shout out to Bianca. She said she was feeling the song. She was
man.
Like, yeah, I like a little wasted. And I don't know who the other little mama was, but shout out to you, too.
Yeah. Man, shout out to y'all for calling in for me, man.
Sure.
I really appreciate
y'all
it. Y'all,
we're going to be right here.
Y'all get me on my Instagram, at Lil Tay Music.
Okay.
That's LilTayMusic.
Mm-hmm.
And that's on Twitter, all the social medias, at Lil Tay Music. So y'all holler at me, man. I mess with all my fans. I follow back. So y'all just holler at me. And, it's gonna be videos on there, everything for you.
Now, Lil Tay, you know next week is our Spring Fest, right?
I do know that now.
Okay, so you gonna come back down here next week for Spring Fest?
Are you inviting me?
Yes.
Well, I'm coming.
Okay, cool. Because we're going to have probate is Monday. Probate is Monday and Tuesday.
Yeah.
DJ 4.0 is going to be at probate.
Well, that's my sister. I got
to
be there.
Yeah, you
exactly. We actually throwing a party at the basement.
When they
getting wasted.
Come through. What's up? Can we get a performance at the party?
What? Because Quinn and D Ray gonna be in the building, so we might as well go and add another legend to the lineup.
What? Is my man, my manager's in here.
Okay, manager.
Nah, man, you know I'd love to be there, man. I'm definitely down for performing, and you know I just love to be in front of the crowds and just to get my music heard to everybody, you know.
Yeah. Definitely. Well, you know, even if you don't be able to come through that day, you're always welcome to come back here.
Always welcome.
When I tell you I'm going to come,
okay?
You know me.
And you know what? Next time, what kind of snacks you like? You like snacks?
Oh, I love snacks.
You like snacks? What kind of food you like?
Oh, man, I like cookies.
You like cookies? What kind of cookies? Like chocolate chip, like snickerdoodle?
I like the Girl Scout cookies.
Girl Scout cookies? Yeah. What kind of Girl Scout cookies?
I like the one with the peanut butter. And then I like the one with the caramel and the like the
circle.
You know what I'm talking about? See, I like the thin mix.
I like the original.
We're going to try to get you some Girl Scout cookies.
Yeah, some Girl Scout cookies.
Some pepperoni pizza or some something. Man, get you some pasta.
And I love bombshells.
You love bombshells? Oh, you love bombshells. But I definitely have one question before we continue. See, y'all don't know what Lil Tay look like, and he is so handsome, y'all. He is fine.
Ain't gonna lie.
Do you eat soul food? Like, do you eat greens? Like, do you eat cornbread? Like, what is it?
I love soul food. I eat anything. Sorry, y'all. I eat all kinds of food. I love all nationalities of food. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, especially man, my partner Jay Black, he's in here. His mama cooks some good soul food.
Man, speaking of Jay Black,
and I be over there on the holidays.
This your homie?
I'm sorry, Jay Black.
Oh yeah, this is one of the artists on the Terrific Records.
Okay,
man.
All right, Jay.
Yeah,
Jay Black ain't trying to say my name, man. I don't know how I feel about that. Dang.
But yeah, so we just pushing that Wasted, man, getting everything out there, and everything's just going good, man. I'm just blessed that y'all have me in here.
Oh, definitely.
Hang out with y'all lovely ladies.
It's a pleasure.
You know, before we end our interview, if you have. You had 30 seconds to say anything to anybody out there. You know, it doesn't matter if you say keep grinding. It doesn't matter if you're saying.
I got you. 30 seconds.
30 seconds right now. Let's go. What would you say?
You got the timer.
I got the timer. One.
I'm sitting.
Two, three.
Oh, she's taking.
I know, y'all.
It's the iPhone. It's the iPhone.
No, chill.
To Steve Jobs, you know.
Steve, my iPhone.
Yeah.
Okay, you ready?
All right, let's do it.
30 on the clock, starting now.
Now. For everybody out there, man, doing music, man, if you believe in what you do, if you believe in anything you do, man, keep grinding. And, man, you're going to be heard, you know what I'm saying? And just for yourself, you know, you love yourself and the love will come, man. And that's all you got to do. She's counting me down. I got 15 seconds. No, 13. Can't be doing that. But, yeah, man, everybody out there just grind, you know, and for whatever it is, if it's music, if it's school, you know, just put your brain down, you know, and just put your foot forward and you can get it, you know. And if I can do it, if I can make it from, you know, all the stuff that I've been through, you know, man, I believe anybody can make it, man. God works miracles.
Oh, yes,
and so, man, if it wasn't for God, you know what I'm saying, the man upstairs, I wouldn't have this album, this Relaxing Blaze album. I wouldn't have any of these songs. I wouldn't have these amazing people around me that I do, you know, and it's just, man, it's a blessing.
It's mad love. It's nothing but love. I'm wasted.